about the plasma membrane. Main important one, diffusion process. Movement of substances from high concentration to low concentration. Last class we discussed about the diffusion process. Okay. And some activities. Activities of the diffusion process. Here, Thomas, very important one. Thomas Graham, important scientist. He, Thomas Graham, he conducted the different types of experiments on diffusion of gases. Diffusion of gases. And ultimately, after several experiments on this diffusion of gases, he studied rate of diffusion of gases. And another important topic studied by Thomas Graham. Thomas Graham is diffusion of gases. Diffusion of gases in different solutions. Ultimately, after several experiments, Thomas Graham stated that more soluble substances, more soluble substances diffuse faster than less soluble substances. Less soluble substances. More soluble substances diffuse faster than less soluble substances. It's a very important proposition. Stated by Thomas Graham. This statement is commonly called as the Graham's law of diffusion. It is also called as Graham's law of diffusion. It's an important one. Observe Thomas Graham. He conducted a number of experiments on the diffusion. diffusion of gases in solutions and diffusion of gases in different types of solutions. Ultimately, he stated that more soluble substances diffuse faster than less soluble substances. Understanding? For example, in last class we conducted different experiments in activities. When we placed the crystals of potassium permanganate in water and red ink in water. Here red ink can soluble in water easily. Understanding? Within a short period, red ink can soluble in water, but crystals of the potassium permanganate take more time to dissolve in water than red ink and powder of the copper sulfate. Means here diffusion of the potassium permanganate takes more time than the red ink and copper sulfate powder. Like this, based on the different types of activities and experiments, Thomas Graham stated a very important proposition, that is, more soluble substances diffuse faster than less soluble substances. Okay, this is very important one here. Observe. Then next next, reverse osmosis. What are the uses of the osmosis process or reverse osmosis? Reverse osmosis. What? Reverse osmosis process. What is reverse osmosis? Already I told you, when high pressure high pressure is applied on when high pressure is applied on high concentrated solution water moves from the high concentrated solution into the low concentrated solution. Through plasma membrane, it is called reverse osmosis process. Osmosis process. Okay, what is the use of reverse osmosis? What is the use of the reverse osmosis? You know, water purifier. Our water purification plants. In this type of plants, reverse osmosis process is used extensively. Why means to purify the water? Okay, to purify the water. Here actually, osmometers or membranes are used, semi-permeable membranes are used in water purifiers. These plasma membranes. Through the plasma membrane, water moves from the high concentrated solution to low concentrated solution. For example, observe one piece. Water purification plants. Okay, under here This is pure water. Here, tap water or salt water. General water. Normal water. This is the semi-permeable membrane. Next, here apply pressure. Okay, here when pressure is applied, what will happen? Water molecules from the tap water, they are transported into the low concentrated water. Now this is the high concentrated water or high concentrated solution. This is the low concentrated solution. When pressure is applied on the high concentrated solution, water molecules move from the high concentrated solution to low concentrated solution. Only water molecules here, not solute molecules. Only water molecules can move from the high concentrated solution to low concentrated solution. This is the reverse osmosis process. Actually, in water purification plants or water purifiers, this type of principle is used here. This type of mechanism is used in water purifier. RO water, reverse osmosis processed water. Okay, RO water means this is the mechanism present in the water purifiers. Other ones, like this pure water. We can get the pure water by using the reverse osmosis process. By using reverse osmosis process, we can separate the only water molecules, from the high concentrated solution. We can separate the only water molecules. This is the mechanism involved in air water purification plant. Yes. Next. Next, another use of diffusant. Use of the diffusant. Use of diffusant is dialysis process. What? Dialysis process. What is dialysis? Dialysis means it is also called as artificial kidney. Observably, it is also called as artificial kidney. What? Artificial kidney. Why dialysis process used? What is the use of dialysis? Dialysis means just you can say filtration of. Filtration of blood to remove the waste materials. Waste materials from the body or from the blood or from the body. Yes, this is called a dialysis process. Why dialysis process is used by the patients? Kidney failure patients. Who? Kidney failure patients. Two kidney failure patients. If two kidney failure patients or persons, waste materials, different types of waste materials, they cannot be removed from the body of two individual persons. If waste materials are accumulated in bodies, they become poisonous and patients or persons may die. That is why waste materials, nitrogenous waste materials, urea, uric acid, ammonia, and other nitrogenous waste materials, they should be removed out of the organism's body. To remove the waste materials, there are no kidneys in organism in which patients, two kidney failure patients. Okay. End stage of renal disease. There are no two kidneys to remove the waste materials from the blood or body. In such conditions, two kidney failure persons, they should check up the dialysis process. Understanding? The dialysis process, a dialyzer is present. Yes, this is dryer and fridge. These are the membranous tubes or channels. Next, this is the dialyzer. The entire instrument is dialyzer. Here, to remove the waste materials from the body, human body, process is used first from the human artery. Blood is taken out into the channel or tube. Then heparin. You know very well that heparin means it is a type of anticoagulant agent which prevents the clotting of blood, coagulation of blood prevents. Okay. Next, from the human body. Blood is collected and this blood is passed through the membranous tube or channel into the dialyzer machine. In dialyzer machine, number of membranous channels or tubes are present. All tubes are embedded in dialyzing fluid means around the membranous tubes, dialyzing fluid is present. It is one type of fluid without any nitrogenous waste material. Okay, now collected blood is traveled through the membranous channels. Means blood contains the large amount of nitrogenous waste materials. Blood contains the large amount of nitrogenous waste materials. Observe carefully. Here, blood with large amount of nitrogenous waste material. Next, dialyzing fluid. What? Dialyzing fluid. Dialyzing fluid is without any nitrogen waste. Nitrogenous waste. Now based on the concentration gradient, diffusion process takes place. From the blade, waste materials are diffused into the low concentrated area. Waste materials from the blade are transported into the dialyzing fluid. Observe, dialyzing fluid as blade travels through the channels or membranous tubes of the dialyzer. What will happen? Diffusion process takes place. Waste materials from the blade are transported out of the blade into the membranous channels. Waste materials are entered into the dialyzing fluid from membranous channels. Understanding? For example, this is a membranous channel or membranous tube. Now this is a blade with more amount of waste material. Now this is the dialyzing fluid without any nitrogenous waste materials. Now what will happen? Now from the high concentrated area, waste materials are diffused into the low waste material concentrated area. Means because of this diffusion, waste materials present inside of the blade, these waste materials can be removed into the dialyzing fluid. Usually this is 3 to 6 hours. This process takes the time for 3 to 6 hours. Dialysis process, observe carefully. Here, collected blade is entering into the dialyzer. In dialyzer, blade travels through the membranous channels or tubes. As blade travels through the membranous channels, waste materials are diffused into the dialyzing fluid from the blade. Okay, result, blade is purified. Ultimately, through the membranous channels, blade is transported out of the dialyzer. Then this blade is again sent into the human body by injecting the heparin and the coagulant agent. Means here entire blade circulates between the human body and dialyzer or dialyzing machine for approximately 3 to 6 hours. Observe carefully.
Please, I will go to the room. मान लीजिए